We've all had that panicky feeling before. While already having driven up the street a quarter mile, the oh shit factor is all too real. Once your mind wanders to the thought of having accidentally left a hot appliance going at the house, you sometimes even get a mental image of your house in flames as a result of your carelessness. I turned my car around for that very reason. I couldn't imagine what would happen if I lost all my precious belongings, all because I was absent-minded like that. It should be a no-brainer to just click that stovetop dial to the off position before taking off for the evening. Shit, 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 I chanted out loud, kicking myself verbally for already being 10 minutes toward my work before having this realization. I think I left the stove on before I left the house. Did I remember to turn off the stove? Because I don't remember. Shit. When I got to my driveway and stepped out of my car, I couldn't make big enough strides toward my front door to calm my nerves. I needed to know if that damn stove was off. I turned the key and popped the lock before barging into my kitchen like a damned madman. My eyes turned to the oven in urgency. There it was, on as on could be. Wow, is all I could muster up to say under my breath. That could have been a disaster had I spent all evening at work without knowing I had left the damn stove going full blast. I could have lost my home, my belongings, and my poor cat. I could feel Dudley, my cat, brushed by my leg. I leaned down to pat him as I breathed a sigh of content. This little guy was my best friend. The thought of a fire that I could have set, accidentally licking at his innocent feline skin, sent chills down my spine. Only a lunatic would hurt such precious creatures like this on purpose. Everything that I held dear could have been gone for such a silly reason. My eyes turned to my countertop next. Jesus, I left my lunch on the counter too, still hot out of the frying pan. I spent all that time frying up my neighbor's fingers and eyes, and I didn't even pack them into my lunchbox. I'm so forgetful sometimes. I chuckled to myself for this reason. Oh well, I thought to myself, I better go double check and make sure I cleaned up all that blood too. I checked the garage where I chopped up John's lifeless body, and the hallway where I had dragged him from after slicing his throat. Everything was tidy and in tip-top shape. Good, I thought. Spotless. I said goodbye to Dudley and then walked back out to my driveway, but stopped when I looked at my vehicle. I had to chuckle again. I left my damned car running.